I think if you talk to any teacher, they would tell you that discipline is important in the classroom. I think the problem is that sometimes we think we're disciplining kids when we're really punishing them, and there's a big difference there. In Webster's Dictionary, these two words are actually very closely related in meaning, but I would disagree that these two words are as close as we think that they are. First of all, similarities between these two words, they're both formative words. They both have to do with shaping a person. Both discipline and punishment shape a person. But I would say the discipline and punishment have different outcomes. They might appear similar on the surface, but they're not. Discipline is always done out of love. Discipline should come from a calm place, a controlled place. Discipline is not humiliating and embarrassing. Discipline always comes with a conversation. Always. Punishment is different. Punishment comes from a place of anger. Punishment comes from offense. Punishment comes from disappointment. Punishments can be harsh and rash. In schools, we see this when we give consequences to kids, when we think that we're disciplining them, when in fact we're just giving them a punishment, because there are not two things present that make it discipline. Number one, I think it's really important as educators that we let kids know when they're going to be disciplined that we're not mad at you. This isn't coming from a place of anger. This is coming from a place of love because I care about how you're going to develop. The second thing that has to be present is an awareness of what the discipline is. It doesn't come as a big surprise. It doesn't slap them in the face. It's a conversation that says, this is what you did. Do you understand what you did? This is going to be the consequence. This is how I'm going to discipline you. And then you stick with that kid through the discipline until there's reconciliation. It could be a hand on the shoulder, it could be a hug, it could be a verbal affirmation, it could just be an eye-to-eye conversation. I think that it's important when we're talking about discipline and punishment to reflect on your own life. Which one of those two did you experience the most growing up? When I ask my kids about it, usually it's one of the two that they experience the most heavily. It's either more discipline or more punishment. Kids and adults kind of answer the same way, like, yeah, I was disciplined a lot, or when I reflect back, I was actually punished a lot. The mindset of distinguishing between discipline and punishment in our classrooms is important because we're guiding kids' hearts. We're helping to shape people here. And obviously it's important as teachers. It's even more important as parents, which many of us teachers are parents. So while we're forming people, whether they're your own sons or daughters or the kids in your classroom, let's always have our discipline come from a place of love, self-restraint, self-control, keeping a big picture mindset in these high tension, high stress, high stakes times.